I have come across such women who constantly say that, you know, I get along more with one particular gender and mere to baaki ho. Matlab, you know, it's like you're disregarding the entire gender and saying mere to kisi ladki se nahi banti. So I feel like that's, I'm sorry, but I'm gonna call you out on your shit and say that that's messed up. It's really messed up. It's not on, girl. So it's like I said earlier as well, like, you know, guys never do that. They never say, oh, meri baaki ladkon se to bilkul nahi banti, mere to ladkiyon se banti hai.
I think there was some part of me that was afraid of being a woman, because I remember when I was young, I used to sort of want to be more like my brother. Like, he'd wear like this watch and have this tan, and I knew that because of the sweat it's going to be stinky. And so I wanted it to happen to me also, so I wore a like this really bad watch and developed a tan, and then used to smell it. And I'd be like, yeah, I'm more like my brother. But I think the where that came from was that I wanted to be considered stronger, more practical, and more solution oriented rather than, you know.
Yeah.
And I didn't want to be considered too emotional or too, you know, whatever you come up with. So I think I have carried that with me. I think the even the literature that I grew up with, which is like, it was Sweet Valley and Full House, and, you know, like, I never read Shakespeare. I only read the abridged version. So, like, I grew up on that stuff, and even the media that you're surrounded by, it's always like the woman is the demonizer. She's the one who's going to steal your boyfriend. She's the one who's a homewrecker. Right?
Or is this how you perceived everything?
So I felt like these are the labels that I picked up on.
Okay.
Like, I find myself measuring myself, like, am I thin? Am I modern enough? Or, like, am I dressed well? Or I don't have ankles.
Somebody told you that.
Like, my legs and my feet are, like, stuck. It's a thing.
I feel like there were two fears that were constantly instilled in me when I was growing up. With men, it was a different kind of fear. With women, it was a different kind of fear. With men, it was like, okay, this guy can come off as perverted or whatever. That fear with strangers.
Yeah.
And in-house, it was like, oh, he's your brother. That's your father. Respect them. Just respect them. And just be scared of them, kind of. Like, you know? And with women, it was like a different kind of fear when I started working, or when I was going to school, or when I was going to a gathering. It was like, don't repeat your clothes because they'll call you out on it. And like, men would never do that, but women might do that. That was constantly like fed to me that, you know, don't wear this, or they'll check it out, or dress in a certain way, because not just for men, but even for women in a particular way, you know. So ye hota tha ki bahut tumhe wo tokega dusra banda. And it's acha ki tum ghar pe theek ho jao, rather than you go out and then you koi aur tumhe ladki bolegi or whatever, you know, even if you're working with women or men or whatever. So, you know, sometimes you'll be having a normal conversation with a guy and he suddenly say that you're not like other girls. I mean, what is that supposed to mean? I'm sorry, do you not get along with other girls? That's a big red alert, red flag right there for a girl. Okay, achha to nahi banti. It's not like something to feel good about, and a lot of girls do, right? Like, when you're in your teens and a guy says that to you, you're not like other girls, you're different, and you're like, wow, okay, I feel better. But it's like, as I'm aging and I feel like I'm in my mid-20s, I feel like you're growing and you're evolving every day. I feel like women tend to understand me more. But it's so weird, guys can be so oblivious. Men can be so oblivious.
Aren't you doing the same thing?
How?
All women and all men.
I know I'm doing that. There's, like I said, there's no black and white here. But as I'm growing up, that's also happening. Like, I have good friendship, but I understand that there are these restrictions that men would never understand.
Yeah.
Like, even if you beat it into the head, maybe they would at some point, but, you know.
I feel like it's new territory as well, but I also feel like the minute I decided to stand up for myself and be more of me and and being okay with, okay, this is my opinion and it might not please everybody, and just believing in kindness and, you know, and being vulnerable, that has allowed other people to pop up in front of me. And I think, like, when I'm that way, I allow others to be that way.
Hmm.
Which is my motto. That be kind and you shall receive kindness.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like we don't know how to build relationships. I think that is my problem. That, I really believe, like, we don't know how to be real with each other. This is something that we have taken in, and I feel like people are not ready to be that uncertain.
Yeah.
You know, if they start thinking, okay, this is where I'm coming from, okay, this is why I don't trust other women, rather than saying I don't trust women. You know?
Yeah.
It'll really, like, put them in a space where then they go to their parents and be like, you did this to me when I was two.
Yeah.